And now it's time for the Cottage Angler, presented by Lucky Strike. More fish fight with Lucky Strike.
Hey guys, this is Mark Menendez from the Strike King Pro Team, and I've got one of my favorite baits here that is extremely productive in the pre-spawn time period when the fish are moving up, getting ready to spawn, and again in the late fall. It's called the Red Eye Shad. It's a bait that has, it's got some characteristics about it that really make it unique in the lipless kind of crankbait family. This bait, when it falls, the key thing about it, instead of hauling like a rock head down, you know, just straight down like a rock, it falls horizontal and has a wiggling, swimming action to the bottom. This gives that bass a chance to see something that's very unnatural in his world. A bass is a predator, man. He's gonna see something natural, see a minnow swimming by, and he's like, well, I've seen that 1,000 times. But if that minnow does something real crazy and wiggles and goes spastic, he's gonna eat it because that's something that he sees in his world not every day. He knows that that's an easy kill and an easy meal. So that's what I'm trying to do with my Red Eye Shad. Lipless baits are notorious good fish catchers by just casting and retrieving. You know, this Red Eye Shad is a great way to catch them on those pre and post spawn type situations. Always remember to lift the rod, keep a good amount of tension with it, watch your line, and you'll see that line jump when they attack it. Lift, watch your line, see it jump. Fiberglass rod, lean into them, wind them to the boat. The great thing about a red eye is the way it falls. And every time it hops up and goes to the bottom, that's just like making a presentation flipping. That's one more cast you made on a long cast. So a long cast, I might get 35 presentations of lift and fall. Make this bait erratic, and you're gonna catch a lot of bass. The key thing is looking for areas out in front of the spawning areas. You know that they're gonna move up on those shallow hard bottoms, grass out in the front, rocks out in the front. Those little transitions before they get to the spawning area is where this red eye shad needs to be fished. In the fall, wind is your friend. I don't care where you're fishing, whether it's Florida or it's up in Canada, I don't care. Wind is your friend in the fall. Wind positions fish, it makes them active, and this red eye shad coming by them at Mach 1, this is a time period that I'm retrieving it extremely fast, where I've got lots of rattles, lots of flash. You've got so many flashy colors in the line here that color becomes very important in that clean water in the fall. Put the wind at your back, hit windy points, windy corners, windy rocks. That will catch those big fish, and particularly those big ugly brown smallmouth. Red eye shad, cold water when they're moving up, cold water when they're moving back out, is a killer to catch big old fish.